Hi there, I hope you're doing well and starting to get into the Christmas spirit. Today, I'm going to be showing you five super simple Christmas card ideas that you can do in under 5 minutes and they'll be perfect for family members. Let's do it. For the first idea, we're going to be painting holly. They are perfect for Christmas and you can just find a simple reference photo online. This is the one that I'm going to be using. We're going to be using a pencil to block in the outlines first, and a holly is a fantastic choice because they're so recognisable that if it's not completely accurate, it doesn't matter. Then you're going to want to grab some clean water and fill in the entire sketch. Today I'm using watercolour. We're going to grab some different colours of green and fill in the leaf. This is also a great time to make sure you've got those sharp points on the edges of the leaf. And this doesn't need to be accurate. You can add whatever shades of green you like. You can add a little bit of blue, a little bit of yellow to add dimension. Really, just make this your own and have fun. Once that's mostly dry, we're gonna grab a red and paint in those berries. Because the water will be mostly dry, it shouldn't blend too much into the leaves at this point. You can also add more definition to the leaves at this point. You can add a stem down the middle and some patterns. And that's the holly complete. It's a super simple idea that you can make in less than 5 minutes. For the second idea, we're going to be painting a fireplace. I have actually done one of these before and it's on my channel. I will leave it down below if you're interested. This is how it turned out and there's a lot of detail in it, but we're going to be simplifying it. The first thing we're going to do is grab a pencil and block in some shapes. For the shape, I am basing it off this painting that I did. We're going to loosely add some bricks on top and some carving around the fire. The trick for this idea is to do lots of little shapes, but leave a gap in between. That's going to be left white. And make sure you don't put the shapes too close to each other, because you're more likely to make mistakes that way. I like to leave really nice gaps in between. I'm going in with watercolor now, but you really can use any medium. Remember, if you're right-handed, work left to right and top to bottom, and do the opposite if you're left-handed. This just stops your hand smudging what you've already painted. We're now going to paint in all those bricks, and I'm working left to right because I'm right-handed. Whilst brown is the base color, feel free to add more orange, yellows, pinks to really bring dimension. I like all of the bricks to be a slightly different shade, but you do you. Once the wood and bricks are complete, we're then going to move on to the fire. Fire is light in the center and around the outside, so a good trick is to grab a nice orange yellow shade and just paint an arch over where the logs would be. Then dab your paintbrush dry. We're going to be blending the paint out around the inside of the arch and around the outside of the arch, so most of the paint will still follow that shape. A good trick is to do a slight stippling motion. So as you're going around the inside of the arch, move the paint in slight circular motions and you should end up with something that looks like a fire. Once that's completely dry, we're then going to paint on the wood. I decided to keep mine really simple and just paint it brown, leaving some white gaps. And that's the fireplace complete. It's such a simple idea and you could easily do this. Moving on to the third idea. This is my favourite of the five and it took 4 minutes 2 seconds, so well within the 5 minutes. For this one, we're going to be painting a reef. And whilst I'm using watercolour, you can also use gouache and acrylic. Grab something round and use a pencil to draw on the outside. That's how we're going to make our circle. First, you need to grab some clean water. And with the paintbrush, we're going to be drawing some squiggly lines around the circle, as you can see now. Now, I'm using a red and green theme, but it's completely up to you whether you want it to look like baubles or plants. You could use gold, silver, any colour that you like. I'm using red and you're going to want to dot some random circles all around the reef. You don't need to add too many because we will be coming back to this. This is really simple if you're using a round brush. We're going to add some leaves, and with a round brush all you need to do is just dab your paintbrush down. We're going to do this the entire way around the reef. Now it's really important that you leave slight gaps for the white to show through, and it's also super important that the leaves follow the direction of the reef. Because some of the paper is already wet, you will see that some of the leaves will blend and some will be harsh, and honestly this gives such a fantastic effect. Once the entire reef is filled, we're going to grab some more red or whatever colour you picked and go over again, adding some more random splashes of colour. Because the water is a little bit more dry, these ones will be more defined. And that's the reef complete. This is my favourite. I really love the way this looks and it's such a simple idea. It's also so fun and anyone can do it. Moving on to the fourth Christmas card idea. It wouldn't be Christmas if we didn't create a Christmas card of a snowman. You can paint snow with watercolor. I've actually made a video on it before where I showed you 4 ways to do it. But it's really difficult, so we're going to do it a simple way. Using any medium, we're going to block in the background. I'm using indigo for this one, but the darker you go, the easier it will be to add the snowman. Once the background is completely filled, we're gonna leave that to dry, and you can use a hairdryer to speed things up. Next, I'm gonna grab my Neo Color Wax Pastels. You can use anything at this stage, pastels, paints, anything opaque will work. Because I'm using my Canson Mixed Media Pad, I have quite a bit of texture on the page. So you'll see that when I add the white blobs, a lot of that will show through. Your snowman could be made up of two or three balls. If you're using quite textured paper that's usually watercolor or mixed media, when the grain of the paper shows through, it looks really professional. I'm keeping mine super simple and doing three blobs, eyes and nose, and some buttons. It's a classic snowman, it's a really simple style, and I'm also using a white pastel to do some sprinklings of snow. This is a really fun and simple idea that I'm sure we've all done before, but by using textured paper, it looks a lot more professional, it looks clean, and it looks like it's taken a lot longer than it did. On to the fifth and final Christmas idea now. This is perfect for parents, family, anyone kind of sentimental. This is a perfect idea. First, you're going to want to find a reference photo. Ideally, this will be just a nice family or couple photo that's kind of iconic and recognizable to your family. I'm just going to be painting this random family I found on Pexels for this example. Even though this is a family portrait, we're going to be keeping it really simple. First, you're going to want to grab a pencil and block in the key shapes. Just rough shapes of the head, the body, arms if they're on show. If they've got any accessories, like in my reference photo with sunglasses, a hat, a helmet, we need to include those. And then block in where the hair sits. Whilst this can be a daunting thing to do, we're going to keep it loose and simple. You can add however much detail you want, but I personally think the ultra simple look is really effective and less likely to go wrong. Next, we're going to grab a pen and fill in those shapes. It's really important that you use a waterproof fineliner at this point. If you don't have one, you can use a colour pencil, and a lot of biros are quite waterproof, but make sure you test it first. Gradually work your way through and line the hair, the face, the bodies. If you want to add detail on the clothes, that's completely up to you, but I've kept mine really simple. I've not even added a face. We're then gonna go in with watercolor, and that's the easiest paint for this method because the lines will still show through. It's up to you whether you want to go for a pastel look or something darker or really bright colors. That's completely up to you. I'm gonna go for a slightly more muted pastel look. At this point, literally just paint in all of the elements. It's up to you whether you want them to blend together and be a little bit messy or whether you want to leave them to dry in between each layer. I quite like the messy look, so I didn't worry about leaving each section to dry. I'm adding each of the clothes and just gradually blending them together, the accessories, the skin tone. Then at this point, I actually decided to grab a hairdryer and dry everything because if I'd have added the hair, it would have just blended together. I'm not worried about shading at all. I'm literally just blocking in the colors. And that's the final idea all done. As I said, I think this one is perfect for parents especially. There's five super simple ideas, so hopefully you'll find one you like. If you do try any out, please let me know down below or tag me on Instagram. I would love to see what you create. Thank you so much for watching. Please consider liking and subscribing to support my channel, and I'll see you on Sunday for a new video. Bye!